Well, here's a simple machining tip that gets round a difficult machining problem. Sometimes if you've got some thin metal or sheet metal to machine, it can be very difficult, because if you just, for instance, put in the vise like this and clamp it up, when the milling cutter hits this, it's going to at best chatter like crazy, or at worst it's going to catch and it's going to bend this, possibly break the cutter, and generally not be terribly useful. In this case, I've got a 6mm plate here, which has been machined on the back side to be flat. The machining was done after this piece was welded onto it. I want to eventually weld this piece on, but I want this surface to be fairly parallel to the bottom, and this was excessively long, so I needed to machine this down, and I needed to machine it square to the bottom. The obvious way is just to clamp it in the vise, but as I've explained, that's not going to work too well. So let's see how I did it and how it actually machined. Firstly, I've clamped the piece in the vise, not by clamping across on the base, but by putting two parallels here so that it clamps up firmly onto the thin metal as high up as possible, leaving the shortest overhung. Secondly, I've cut this piece of wood so it's just a nice fit inside the gap, and then I clamp the sheet metal to this wooden block. That supports this quite well. Back here, this is reasonably well supported anyway. So let's see how we get on. Well, it's working pretty well. No chatter at all. No vibration along this length because it's well supported. There's a little bit of vibration here, but nothing like the amount it would be without that wooden block and clamp. Well, that's it. It's now machined down to size, and it's flat and parallel so that I can add this block onto it. That's all there is to it. But if I hadn't done that, it would not have been an easy job. Well, this is a pass on a couple of tips when milling, which I've found very useful. There's some display cutouts in the top of this project box. I'm cutting out a rectangle. Now I just have to finish off this piece about 5mm more and then come up here. But if I did it unsupported, what's likely to happen is as I start to cut this will get more and more flexible. You can see I can easily bend that there, and it will start to vibrate. And when it finally gets to the stage, it will probably break off rather than allow itself to be cut right to the end. When it breaks, if we're lucky, it might just fall to the ground and that's the end of it, but sometimes it will catch the tool. I'm using quite a small tool, small diameter tool here, and that could easily get broken, and then a piece of the machined off pieces could easily damage the surface that we've got there. So, and we'd end up with a less than a perfect job and a broken milling cutter. Now also, there is another hole there, but let's treat them one by one. So what I'm going to do on this one is just take a small G clamp
put it on here. It's just come past there. It's not the easiest thing to tighten up because of this being in the way. But right, there we are. Okay. So with that on there now, that won't vibrate, and with a bit of luck, it'll cut off cleanly. Let's see how it goes. Now we can see that with the clamp in place, there is no drama at all. Take that off, and we've got a perfect cut. Now on this other one, which I did previously, you can see I've left two pieces here. The reason for that is, as you can see, it was clamped in the vise this way, and the material is very thin. So if I come along here, milled all the way across there, then there'd be very little support in the vise for the clamping forces this way, and it could well close up and loosen the grip of the vise on this piece, which wouldn't be terribly good. So I'd have two pieces here, so it had a full strength more or less across here to take the clamping forces. Now I'm going to employ the same trick that I did here. I'm going to put it back in the vise, put a clamp on one edge here, and finish off on these two pieces. So that's back in there. I'll put it along a bit because then it's clamping in the vise against this fairly solid piece here. Let's put this in about the right position and see if where I can get the clamp. Well, this clamp certainly won't go there on either side, but I've got this small one which I may just be able to get in there. No, okay, so we need plan B. Well, plan B is to use a couple of these spring clamps, which are much lower profile, so I have more room on the back edge, so I'll put the big one there. And I'll put the small one on there. It's not holding it as tight as the G clamps, but it should do the job with a bit of luck. Well, that was that edge, and that was done without any drama. Now I move the clamp in a little bit more if I can. I need to line up on the other side, and that will give me plenty of room to put the big clamp back on. I think might get pushed out of the way, but we'll see. I don't have a good view of it. There we are, nothing broken, and a nice finish on both sides. That's all there is to it. Just a little hint that I found useful. Well, this is it. All nicely cut out. I've deburred it. These holes are for a bunch of switches. I won't be using all of them, but as I had space, I thought I would put some spares in, which would make it simpler in the future if I needed to. This is the display that needs to go behind, so that will fit in there nicely. And then there's another one to fit in this space. If you like this video or any of the others, please share, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click the button to receive updates of any other videos. Thanks for watching.